गुड डे चिल्ड्रेन, एडवोकेट बापू साहेब भोंडे हाई स्कूल वेलकम यू ऑल इन अवर डिजिटल लर्निंग सेशन। चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे इन अवर ईवीएस 2 पीरियड वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू अवर लेसन नंबर 12। बिफोर दैट वी विल स्टार्ट, लेट मी विश यू अ वेरी हैप्पी न्यू ईयर 2021। Children, in our previous video of part 1 of this lesson, we studied that how Murar Baji fight with his sword, moving ahead like lightning, cutting the throats of the soldiers, broke the heads of some and pierced the hearts of the enemies. He was a strong and brave man. Indeed. Now, children, you know, Diler Khan watched all this in admiration and he was shocked to see the bravery of this great man, Murar Baji. So, children, let's start our part 2 of this lesson, lesson number 12. The Siege of Purandar and the Treaty with the Mughal Emperor. So, pay attention here. Murar Baji's incomparable valor. Seeing Diler Khan, Murar Baji asked his troops to attack in full force and himself advanced towards Diler Khan. Whoever tried to obstruct him was cut to pieces. Children, now we all know that the Mughal troops at last surrounded this Murar Baji on all sides. Why? Because Murar Baji along with his soldiers had entered the camp of Diler Khan with lots of bravery. Now surrounded by all the Khan's men, he was still not scared. He fought very bravely. Now pay attention here. I will read for you. The Mughal troops at last surrounded Murar Baji on all sides. Just then, Diler Khan shouted, "Wait! Hold back your swords." The Mughal troops halted and moved back a little. Then Diler Khan addressed Murar Baji, "Until now, I have not seen a swordsman like you. You come over to our side. I promise you complete safety. The emperor will make you a sardar and reward you with a jagir." His eyes red with anger, Murar Baji said in return, "We are the loyal servants of Shivaji Maharaj." So children, here Diler Khan shouted, "Wait," he said, "hold back your swords." Then Diler Khan said this to all his soldiers. And immediately he moved and spoke to this great man, Murar Baji. What did he say? He told him that, "I am very happy with your bravery. And I have never seen a soldier, a swordsman like you. Please come over to our side." Children, what did he mean? He was calling Murar Baji to the side of the Mughal emperor. And he said, "I also promise you your complete safety. You will also be rewarded with the jagir." Children, we have seen in the previous lesson how when a Maratha Sardar went in the service of the Sultan or the emperor, they were rewarded with the jagirs. But this brave man, Murarbaji, did not want anything. He said, "We are loyal servants of Shivaji Maharaj." Now pay attention here. Murarbaji says, "Who wants to buy safety from you? Why should we come over to your side? And who wants your emperor's jagir?" He then moved forward in the direction of Dilair Khan and again started attacking his soldiers. Dilair Khan, who was seated in the huda on the elephant's back, released an arrow which pierced Murarbaji's neck. Murarbaji fell to the ground. His followers lifted his dead body and took it back to the upper fort. What if one Murarbaji is fallen? We too are brave like him. We will fight with courage. Saying so, they began to fight again without losing heart. So children, here Murarbaji became very angry. He says to Dilair Khan, "Who wants your jagir? Who wants your safety?" "We don't want anything," he said. And he continued to move forward to fight against the Mughal emperor. Now Dilair Khan again started attacking him. Even his soldiers joined him. Dilair Khan was seated on the back of an elephant. He released an arrow which pierced Murarbaji's neck. Sad to say, Murarbaji fell dead on the ground. But his followers did not lose heart. They carried the dead body of the Murarbaji, took it at a side, keep it there, and continue to fight on the upper fort. Discontinued, these brave soldiers went ahead fighting with great courage. So, let's see what happened next. I will read for you. Pay attention. Shivaji heard the news with great sorrow. He knew that he could hold each one of his forts against the Mughal army for at least more than a year. But he was unwilling to do so at the cost of his men, who would die in the attempt. Now, here, when the news of the death of his great soldier, the brave soldier Murarbaji, reached Shivaji, he was full of sorrow. He was sad and did not want to lose any of his brave men in the battle. He knew that his soldiers were brave. They could stand against the Mughal army for at least a year or even more. But he did not want to do it at the cost of his men, and so he wanted to put an end to the wars and bloodsheds. Treaty of Purandar. What could be done? He was not strong enough to fight the powerful Mughals. All his political skills was also of no avail. There was only one thing he could do. He decided on a temporary withdrawal from the fight. He would enter into a treaty with the Mughal emperor. He went and saw Jai Singh. This was a very sensible and statesman-like thing to do. He said to Jai Singh, "Mirza Razi, You are a Rajput. You can understand our suffering. The emperor's campaigns have laid the country waste, and people are in great misery. I have undertaken this task of establishing Swaraj so that people may be happy. You should join me in this uphill task. If you agree to lead us, myself and my mawlas will be your trusted followers. Now, we know that Shivaji was sad on the death of his brave Sardar or the soldiers like Murar Baji. And so, what did he do? He wanted to end with all the wars and fights. And so he decided to sign a treaty with the Mughal emperor. So he went and met Jai Singh. This was a very sensible and statesman-like thing to do. Now this Mirza Raje Jai Singh was a Rajput. Shivaji told him that, "You understand our sufferings, the emperor's campaigns all over Maharashtra has brought a lot of suffering, agony among the people. And you know that I wanted to establish Swaraj to make the people happy. But they are not. And so he said, if you will join hands with me, myself and my mawlas will be your trusted followers." So let's see what happened. Jai Singh was a shrewd diplomat. He persuaded Shivaji to sign a treaty of peace with the emperor. Shivaji signed the treaty, and according to its terms, 23 forts and a territory with a revenue of 4 lakh ons, a gold coin, were to be handed over to the emperor. The Treaty of Purandar was signed in 1665. So children, now this Jai Singh was a very shrewd diplomat. He thought for a while and he asked Shivaji to sign the Treaty of Peace with the emperor. Now Shivaji also wanted to have peace, and so he decided to sign the Treaty of Peace with the Mughal emperor. Shivaji also wanted to have peace, so he decided to sign the treaty with the Mughal emperor. According to the treaty, Shivaji had to give 23 forts and a territory with a revenue of 4 lakh ons. Children, ons means a gold coin. Now the Treaty of Purandar was signed in the year 1665. After the treaty was signed, Jai Singh suggested to Shivaji that he should go to Agra and see the emperor. He also guaranteed Shivaji's safe return. Shivaji thought over the suggestion. He knew that the emperor could not be trusted. He had proved treacherous to his own brothers. But in the end, Shivaji decided to take the risk and face the situation as cautiously as he could. He informed Jai Singh that he was willing to go to Agra to meet the emperor. Now, after the treaty was signed, what happened? Mirza Raje Jai Singh suggested to Shivaji that he should go to Agra and meet the emperor. Now, Shivaji knew that it was not safe. Shivaji also knew that the emperor could not be trusted, but he still decided to take the risk and face the situation. So he informed Mirza Raje Jai Singh that he was willing to go to Agra and meet the emperor. Children, you know that in olden days, you had to take a lot of risk to achieve something. Shivaji had taken a lot of risk in his life to achieve many of the forts and many of the things. He lost many of the lives of his friends, relatives, but he never got disappointed. He moved further and further. Students, Shivaji was willing to meet emperor who was in Agra. Now, we will see in the next chapter what happened. Okay? So, kindly subscribe our channel to get more videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.